Yes, good morning everyone. How are you all?
Fine.
Very good. Just recall whatever we learnt in circles. The first theorem, what we have done? In the circle, two equal cards, we subtend equal angles at the center, and afterwards, that is converse. If the central angles are equal, then the chords will become equal. And next one, we have proved that the chords, if you are drawn a perpendicular, that perpendicular will divide the chord into two equal parts. Converse, if the chord is divided into equal parts, then the line will be perpendicular. Are you understanding? Then like that only we have drawn today. Yesterday, last class we have studied the angle subtended by the arc at the center is double of the remaining subtended by the same arc in the remaining portion or remaining segment. Okay, na? Today we'll solve this one more important theorem. It is based upon the eighth theorem. The angles in the same segment of a circle are equal. For example, it is a circle. Consider a circle. In this circle, for example, there are two segments. Otherwise, yes. This is center. You can do like this. Here it is O, A, B, C, and D. So we have to do that. A, B, C equal to A, B, C. Very, very simple. See, for example, if angle AOC is equal to x degrees, then by the theorem, what theorem? This arc is subtended, the angle at the center will be double of that angle subtended by the remaining portion, by the same arc in the remaining portion. If it is x means, then what about A, B, C? Yes, who will tell? 100%. It will be angle A, B, C will be half of A, O, C. It is nothing but x by 2 degrees. Then what about this same A, B, C? Then what about ABC? Angle ABC. Okay? That is also equal to, by the theorem, ABC equal to half of ABC. Here half of ABC is there, here also half of ABC is there. Both right hand side equal means, what about the left side? Both are equal. Therefore, by 1 and 2, angle ADC will be equal to ABC. Okay? Now, clear proof? Yes. Now, this is a circle. ADC and ABC are on the same segment. Then, we have to do that the angles formed in them also equal. Very, very simple. Now, in the first one, angle AOC is equal to, first you take this, 2 times of angle ADC. This is one. Next one, again angle AOC equal to 2 times of S, angle
in the center is equal to double of the angle subtended by the same arc in the remaining portion. Therefore, yes, since angle left hand sides of LHS of 192 are equal, therefore 2 times of ADC is equal to 2 times of ABC, 2 cancel, therefore angle ADC equal to angle ABC. Okay, na? Any doubt, please? Yes? Very good. Okay. One more theorem. Only theorems, only more are there in this. Compared to problems, theorems are more. So please learn them, practice them, then apply them. Then only you will get some knowledge. This chapter will be based upon all the theorems only. If you know the theorem, then the problem will be very easy. Okay? Yes, one more theorem. This theorem is very simple. For example, a circle is there. In this, one quadrant will form like A, B, C, D. Then we have to prove that if A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral, then their sum, either sum, this two or this two will be 180 degrees. Either angle A plus angle C equal to 180 or angle B plus angle D will be equal to 180. That's all. We have to prove like this only. Shall we prove? Pakka? Very simple. Okay, na? I'll prove like this. Take this center. O is the center. Now tell me, according to this, angle DOB equal to what? So two times of. Otherwise, no problem. You can do like this. Angle DOB equal to 2 times of DAB. That means what? If I am taking X, then what about this? This will be, otherwise you can take this as I will write DOB equal to 2 times of AB, otherwise angle DAB equal to half of DOB. Okay. I will take this as X. Therefore, what happened? This will be 2X. If I have taken this as 2Y, then what about this? It is nothing but y. Correct or not? Yes? Yes. Very simple. Okay? Now you can do this. If it is 2y, it is. If it is 2x, it is x. If it is 2y, it is y. Then very simple. Now, what is the sum of angles at that point? Yes, it is 360. 2y plus 2x is equals to 360. Therefore, if you take 2 common, y plus x equal to 360. Therefore, x plus y is equals to 360 by 2 is equals to 180. Therefore, what are x plus y means? Yes. Angle A plus angle C will be 180. If these two are 180 means automatically angle B plus angle D is also 180. Why tell me? Because in a quadrilateral, the sum of the angles will be always 360 degrees only. Okay na? Yes, I will tell the proof. Just a simple. Yes. Let angle DOB equal to 2x degrees and reflex of angle DOB equal to 2y degrees. Therefore, by the theorem, what theorem you know? If a arc is subtending angle at the center, this will be double of this. Right? This will be double of this. Yes. Otherwise, this will be half of this. By the theorem, we know that angle DAB equal to half of DOB. It is nothing but half of x, 2x, it is nothing but 2 cancel, it is nothing but x degrees. Second one, angle reflex of angle DOB is equals to, yes, now I have to take reflex of DOB, don't want for me. Yes, angle DCB is equals to half of reflex of angle DOB. It is nothing but half into 2y, 2 cancel y degrees. This is 2 and this is 1. But the sum of the angles at the center, of a circle is 360 degrees. Correct or not? Now try. Therefore, what happened? 2x plus 2y equal to 360 degrees. Correct? Yes. This plus this. But 2 you take common, x plus y is equals to 360. Therefore, x plus y equal to 360 by 2 equal to 180. That means what happened? X and y means? Yes. That is angle A plus angle C equal to 180. Therefore, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, na? That's all. This is the proof. Please take down. Yes, one more small theorem. Angle formed in the semicircle is a right angle. Very, very simple. See, I will take like this. It is a circle. Take the diameter. This is O. This is A, this is B. And take any angle. See. Now you tell me what is the angle value of ACB is equals to half of AOB. Half as it is. Correct or not? Yes, since it is a straight line, have it on the straight line or not? Straight line means the sum of the angles at O is how much? Anyone? Yes, very good. 180. Therefore, 2 1 ja, 180. Therefore, what is the angle? 180. If no sir, you can take like this. If it is also same, because the definition will be same. No sir, I will take like this.
same. I will take like this. No, same. I will take like this. I will take like this.
However you want, you can take. But they should be in the semicircle only. Then only this will apply. Otherwise it won't apply. Did you understand? Yes. Now I will prove very simply. Same only. Just you see how to write the step. Data. What data is there? AOB is a diameter. That's all. Okay, na? Now, to prove what we have to prove, angle ACB equal to 90 degrees. Okay, now, by the theorem, what theorem do we know? The angle subtended by the arc at the center will be double of the angle subtended in the remaining part. That's all. Therefore, either you can write like it or like this. There is no problem. Therefore, angle ACB equal to half of angle AOB. But AOB is a diameter. Diameter is what? It is a straight line. Correct or not? Therefore, angle ACB equal to half of 180 degrees. Straight line is 180 or not? Yes? Yes. 180, 21, 290. Therefore, what is this angle? 90 degrees. So, whichever you draw angle, but in the semicircle. If you draw like this also, you will get same only. Here I have drawn. This is perpendicular only. I have drawn like this. It is also 90 degrees. But you should be in the semicircle. Did you understand? Yes, please take out. Yes. Come to 10.5 exercise. The first problem is like this. If in a circle it is given like this, what is the value of angle ADC? Yes, any guesses please? No. Very simple problem. You see, the problem is like this. This is 60 plus 30, how much? It is 90. Then what about this angle? Anyone? Yeah. This will be, x will be equal to half of 90 degrees. That is nothing but how much? Part. This much only answer. Okay? Are you understanding? It is like this or not? If you take reverse, it is like this only. 60 plus 30, AOC. Then what about DC? ADC will be equal to half of AOC. So what is AOC? How much AOC is there? 90. 90 divided by 2? 40. Okay, na? Yes. Let's see now. Very, very simple. How to draw this? Now, angle AOC is equal to angle AOB plus angle BOC. It is nothing but equal to 60 degrees plus 30 degrees is equals to 90 degrees. By the theorem or by one of the theorems, ADC is equals to ADC is equals to half of angle AOC. Therefore, half into 90 degrees, 2 ones, 2 fours, 2 5. Therefore, what is the angle? Yes. Therefore, angle ADC is equals to 45 degrees. Did you understand? Yes, very very simple, right? Yes, come to second problem. Very simple problem. In this, the specialty of this figure is here AB is a chord. AB is a chord that is equal to its radius. Equal to its radius means what? Here OA equal to AB equal to OB. Therefore, which type of triangle is this? Anyone? Either scalene or equilateral or isosceles. Which triangle? Equilateral triangle. What is the sum of the angles in the equilateral triangle? Don't. Very very simple. You see, for example, take like this. PQR, in this all sides are equal. In that, yes. We know that we have seen in part in triangle that the angles which are opposite to equal sides are equal. Therefore, these two if you take, these two angles are equal. If you take these two, then these two angles will be same. That means what happened? All angles are equal. But whether all angles are equal, all angles are different, or two angles are different, but the sum of the angles will be same only or different? Same only. Because it is the angle sum property of a triangle. Therefore, you can write directly angle P plus angle Q plus angle R equal to 180 degrees. But what you can write? Angle P equal to angle Q equal to angle R. Therefore, 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 1 plus 1. Therefore, it will be angle P is equals to 180. Therefore, angle P equal to 180 by 3. How much it is? 60 degrees. Now, very good. Now, central angle for this triangle is 60 degrees. Yes. Now, who will tell? It is 60 means what about this? Anyone, please? Anyone? Very simple. The arc, that is ADB arc, is there now? This will subtend an angle at the center. How much it is? 60 degrees. Then this will be, yes, double of the angle which is formed on the other side. Other side means this arc is there now on the other side of the arc. Then it will be, that is, angle AOB is equals to 2 times of angle ACB, or ACB equal to AOB, we know that, divided by 2. Therefore, angle ACB equal to 30 degrees. Therefore, how much it is? Very good, 30 degrees. Now, who will tell? What about ADB? Anyone, please? Very simple. Like this only. Angle ADB reverse is nothing but, yes, half of reflex of AOB. Now, this is 60 means what about the reflex? No, no. Very simple. Sum of the angles in a circle, how much? Otherwise the angle at the center is how much? It is 360. In this 360, 60 gone. Therefore, how much it is? 300. It is nothing but half into 300. 2 ones, 2 ones, 2 5. Therefore, what is the angle? 150 degrees. Therefore, so we found either side also in the same arc also. The angles are, we have to find out the angles. Therefore, one is 30. And one is a 150. Okay na? Yes, let me explain very clear. Simple problem. Yeah. In this special figure, the property is, sorry, the question is, yes, the question is, take one card. AB is a card. This card is equal to the radius of the circle. Equal to the radius of the circle means what happened? OA is equals to AB is equals to OB. Okay, na? So you can write directly. Since the radius or the chord drawn is equal to the radii or radius of the circle, that is AB equal to OA equal to OB. Now in this triangle, this side and this side are equal. Which type of triangle? Yes. Therefore, AOB is an equilateral triangle. Is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, you know that the sum of the angles is equals to in equilateral triangle, what you have to do in this? All angles are equal. Therefore, the sum of the angles is nothing but how much? 180. All angles are same or not? Therefore, x plus x plus x. Otherwise, angle A plus angle O plus angle B equal to 180. All are same. Therefore, 3x equal to 180. Therefore, x equal to 180 by 3. It is nothing but how much? 60 degrees. Very good. Therefore, angle, how much it is? AOB is equal to 60 degrees. Now, take that. Angle ACB equal to half of angle AOB, because by you can write one of the theorems. In examination, you can't write like this. What you can write? Because the angle subtended at the center by the arc is equal to twice of the angle which is formed on the other side of the arc. Did you understand? Yeah. Now it is nothing but equal to half. AOB, how much it is? Now only we put, we found 60 degrees. 2 1s, 2 30. Therefore, ACB equal to how many degrees? Okay, na? Now next, similarly we can prove angle ADB equal to half of reflex of angle AOB is equals to half. Reflex means what? Already 60 degrees is there. Since it is a circle, therefore angle at the center is 360 degrees. The remaining will be how much it is? 360 minus 60 is nothing but 300 degrees only. 300. Therefore, 2 1s, 2 1s, 2 5s. Therefore, how many degrees? 150 degrees. Therefore, how many angles we should find out? We form on the same segment and on the other side. Therefore, angle ACB equal to 30 and angle ADB equal to 150 degrees. Did you understand? So like this, we have to find out the angles. Please take down. Yes, third problem, very simple problem. If angle PQR is equals to 100 degrees, then what about OPR? ORP. Very, very, very simple. Okay? Now let me explain. Physically now, very simple. since it is 100 degrees, therefore Wiener theorem, what about this? Yes, 2 times of this, 2 times of this, it is nothing but 200 degrees. Yes, if it is 200, what about this? Yes, it is 160 degrees. Now consider POR triangle. Sum of the angles will be how much? 180 degrees. That means what? In OPR, in OPR, angle O plus angle P plus angle R is equals to 180. But angle O, how much is there? 160. Since OP and OR are radii, therefore these two are same angles only. Therefore, if I am writing x, this also x, 180. Therefore, x plus x, 2x, 180 minus 160. Therefore, it is only 20 degrees. Therefore, x equal to 20 by 2. It is nothing but 10 degrees. Therefore, this also 10 degrees and this also 10 degrees. Did you understand? Very simple proof. Okay? Let me explain in detail. Yeah. See the problem now. Very, very simple. You can write in the figure. In the given figure, angle PQR equal to 100 degrees. Okay, na? Yes. Now write by one of the theorems. Angle POQ equal to 2 times of angle PQR is nothing but 2 into 100 equal to 200. Therefore, reflex of angle POQ is equals to 360 minus angle POR. POR, yes, POR. POR is not POQ, it is POR. Yes. It is nothing but equal to 360 minus 200. It is nothing but equal to 160. Right? Next. In triangle POR, what happened? OP is equals to OR. Why? Because OP and OR are the radii of the given circle. OP equal to OR, therefore what happened? OPR is equals to ORP. Therefore, by angle sum property, by angle sum property of a triangle, yes, what happens? Yes, angle POR plus angle PRO, angle RPO is equals to 180 degrees. POR, how much is there? 160. Since these two are equal, no? Therefore x plus x is equals to 180. 2x equal to 180 minus 160 is equals to 20 degrees. Therefore, x equal to 20 divided by 2 equal to 10 degrees. Therefore, both the angles are equal to 10 degrees. Okay? Please take down. Yes, one more problem you see, please. Angle ABC equal to 69 degrees and angle ACB equal to 31 degrees. Then find BBC equal to how much? Very, very simple. Just to see. In this triangle, in ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 because it is a triangle. What is angle A? Don't know, right? Angle A. What is angle B? 69. In this, what is angle C? 31 equal to 180. Therefore, angle A equal to 180 minus 69 plus 31, it is nothing but 100. P is how much? A. Angle A equal to 180 means what about D? Anyone? It is also 80 only because angles on the same, in the same segment are equal. We have proved the theorem. Correct or not? Therefore, it is 80 means what about this? This is also 80 only. Okay, na? So take the proof in detail. Very, very simple. Yes. In this figure, he has given that angle ABC equal to 69 degrees and angle ACB equal to 31 degrees. Find BDC, that is BDC. Very, very simple. Now, write up. Given, what he has given? Angle ABC equal to 69 degrees and angle ACB equal to 31 degrees. ACB. Right? Now consider the triangle ABC. Therefore, you can write ABC plus BCA plus BAC is equals to 180. You can write down here because of angle sum property. You can write angle sum property of a triangle. Angle sum property of a triangle. Very, very simple. Now ABC, don't know. ABC how much has given? 69 degrees. BCA is 31 degrees plus BAC, don't know, like that. Okay, na? Now very simple. Angle BAC is equals to what happened? 180 minus 69 plus 31. How much? Add into the figures only. Very simple. 9 plus 1, 10. 4 plus 6, 10. 100 degrees. How much? 100. It is nothing but how much? 80 degrees. Now observe BAC and BDC lying on the same segment. Therefore, both are equal. But angle BAC and BDC are in the same segment. Therefore, angle BAC is equals to angle BDC equal to 80 degrees. Okay, na? Please take down this class. Yes, see the problem. He has given that angle BEC is equals to 130 degrees and ACD equal to 20 degrees. Okay, na? Very, very, very simple. You see, it is a straight line, correct or not? BD is a straight line. It is 130 degrees. What about this? Yes, 50 degrees. Now, take this triangle BEC. Angle D plus angle E plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. In 180, 70 gone. Therefore, what happened? Angle BDC equal to 180 minus 70. It is nothing but 110 degrees. But he asked us to find out BAC. But here BDC is equals to BAC. Tell me why? Because both are lying on the same side. Therefore, both are equal to 110 degrees. Okay, na? Yes. Let me explain briefly. Yes. So very simple. Write down first what he has given. Given that angle BEC is equals to 130 degrees and ACD equal to 20 degrees. Right. Since BD is a line, therefore, therefore angle BEC plus angle CED equal to 180 degrees because it is a straight line, correct or not? Therefore, BEC how much? 130 plus angle CED equal to 180. Therefore, CED equal to 180 minus 130 is nothing but equal to 50 degrees. Okay, na? Right. Intriangle, very, very simple. Intriangle CDE, angle C plus angle D plus angle E equal to 180 degrees. But E how much, C how much is there? Yes, 20 degrees. D, don't know. Plus E, 50 degrees. Is equals to 180. Therefore, angle D equal to 180 minus 70. It is nothing but 110 degrees. That is, angle BDC is equals to 110 degrees. But, why should we write by? But BAC and BDC are in the same segment. In the same segment. Therefore, angle BAC equal to angle BDC equal to 110 degrees. Okay, na?
Yes.
Very good. Please take down.